this has been what we'd call a major El Nino in that we've had above normal precipitation, above normal snowpack in the mountains. We've had near record precipitation in December, followed by very heavy precipitation in March as well, with above normal throughout the rest of the period. So overall, the total rainfall and snowfall combined has been very well in the mountains. We're above average to very much above average in most basins across the state. In 2015, at this point in time, we only had 52 of 147 snow measurement sites measuring snow. This year, we only have 10 snow-free sites, so that's a big difference there. Additionally, we were under 30% in all basins statewide of percent of normal snowpack at this point in time last year, whereas now the lowest would be 89% in any particular basin. So overall, we're in a much better situation. For stream flows, our current forecasts as of March 1 are indicating very near normal conditions, and that is due to the above normal snowpack which we're seeing across the state. If we have a cooler spring with cooler temperatures near normal or below normal, that'll delay the snowpack runoff to later in the year, which will sustain our stream flows into the fall. However, if we have warm temperatures, which some forecasts are indicating, and drier conditions, the snowpack could melt out sooner and we would have potential for water shortages earlier in the year due to the runoff occurring so early. As of April 1, most El Nino forecasts have the conditions drying out and with less precipitation below normal precipitation. If we have that scenario occur, we could melt our snowpack off sooner. In this case, we've had the above normal precipitation, so it sets us up rather well for sustained stream flows if we don't warm too quickly and dry out too quickly.